Jurassic Park. What must I say? A beautiful, well put together, action packed, emotional franchise. For the most part. Today I aim to rank each of the films from this beloved pentology, soon to be 6 films. Here are my terms and policies for the video, and now let's begin. Fallen Kingdom is a hot, hot mess. I have never seen a movie that has as bland characters as this one. The plot of this movie is just a lost world again, except with the added twist that they're selling dinosaurs. Wow, how creative and interesting. I can't say I absolutely despise this one because I don't. Honestly, I don't even care. This is the only film that I can say was solely made for money. If selling the dinosaurs was the climax, why did it happen halfway through the movie? Why is Macy a clone? Why does the villain have literally no personality at all? Where did this Benjamin Lockwood guy come from, and how did he not know there was a secret basement underneath his house? Why did J.A. Bayona direct this movie? It's J.A. Bayona. I don't know, and I really don't care. Can you tell me how Owen or Claire progress in the slightest, besides learning how to kiss more aggressively? Owen is a literal god in this movie, and that's not a compliment. At least he was cool in the first movie, but here there's no tension if he's gonna survive. He's Owen Grady. That Franklin kid also gets on my nerve, along with everyone else in this movie. I don't know what to say. Hybrids were already not a very interesting idea in the first place, so I don't see why they decided the main dino antagonist should be one again. The climax is just stupidly long. How does a dinosaur movie make me bored? Explain. None of the dinosaurs besides the Indo are scary. They try once with the Carnotaurus, but oh no, the T-Rex needs to be here because we gotta have poster covers, I guess. Nobody learns a lesson here, and I can't point out a particular theme except don't illegally sell dinosaurs at an auction. I don't know, guys, this movie isn't even worth getting angry over. It just feels so lifeless and dead. It's still a 4 out of 10 movie just because I think it has its moments. The premiere is pretty good. The action sequences are all pretty good, even if they don't have no direction or meaning. Some people don't mind this one, but personally it's my least favorite to rewatch, and the worst in general. I'm sorry. Amblin, do better. Now, before you send the military to hunt me down with a dozen of 10-ton tanks, please understand that I do not think The Lost World is a bad film. In reality, the gap between this movie and Fallen Kingdom is comical. It's just not as good as my top 3, I think. In fact, The Lost World is a good movie, just not perfect. I think what I can really appreciate about this film is how it's trying to tell its own story. It doesn't have to directly link to the first for the plot to make sense. It has its own direction and follows it. However, I think that's also where this one also falls flat. I think sometimes it can just feel like it's trying too hard to beat the original, which it obviously doesn't in my eyes. It's also the film I watched the least out of the whole franchise. I've only watched it like 80 times, which is nowhere near the amount I watched the other 4. It's not because it's the least enjoyable, but I do think it is a little bit difficult to watch it sometimes. Some parts are really slow, especially the first 30 minutes, as well as some of the second act. I think the cast is definitely the thing this movie got right. I've never been crazy about Jeff Goldblum as Ian Malcolm, however, I think he did perfectly in this film. I also think the other characters like Eddie, Sarah, and even Kelly did fine. I don't think the villain and the casting is quite as interesting. Most of them are lifeless, well, except their death scene, golly, Dieter. However, I did really enjoy Roland Timbo. He served as a really compelling, almost neutral character. Ludlow was fine too, I guess. The dino stuff in this movie, on the other hand, was epic. Anytime Buck was on screen, it was a blast. A scary one, at that fact. However, I didn't really care for the raptors as much. They were a lot more forgettable in this one compared to the first, which is a shame. I think it had to do with the fact that they weren't foreshadowed as much. They just kind of came out of nowhere. This one also differs from the book a lot, which I don't think is a big deal to most people, but I thought it was worth pointing out. Man, I really want to see a Carnotaurus. Oh well, I think the end product for The Lost World was well received and pretty satisfactory, but that's about it. Dare I say it, The Lost World is a movie. I know, shocking. Not at all did I think JP3 of all movies would make it halfway up the list. However, for some reason, this one really works for me. When it originally came out, I wasn't even born when it was released. What I meant to say was when I first watched the movie in like 2012 or something, I loved it. That probably had to do with one fact. The Spinosaurus, baby! Spinosaurus is my literal favorite dinosaur of all time since I was like 3. Now that I'm 14, I realize how to be a decent film critic. Don't judge a movie by one aspect. The thing about this one is it isn't one I constantly enjoy and is compelling all the way through, like Jurassic World. It has some really awful stuff, some of the worst things in the franchise, but it also has some of my favorite things. One thing that has always kept been captivating to me about this film is how it's not trying to be better than the original, unlike someone here. However, like The Lost World, it also tells its own story while still connecting to the other two. Lost World is probably a better sequel, but because there's a lot more world-building with Sorna and stuff. However, I think JP3 is indeed a better movie. I love the idea of having a full-on survival story. Yes, I know the first two films had survival-esque parts to them. However, not like this movie. In those two, they have resources to help them. In this one, every character is stripped of everything they have. And yes, we'll talk about the main cast in a second. I think bringing Sam Neill back to play Alan Grant was a perfect choice, since I kind of missed him after The Lost World. Wait, that doesn't even make any sense. I could just watch these one after another. Oh well, I was still dying to have him back in the film. He's also portrayed in a very different light than the first, which I think was a really good move. I like how he's bent on not going back to either the islands, but money tips him over. I like how he's portrayed to be a bad person, and the film doesn't shy away from that, just like the first movie with him and the kids. There's also Billy. Yeah, this dude's just kind of a ripoff of Nick Van Owen, who, by the way, is probably my favorite character in The Lost World, and I'm sorry I didn't mention him. Billy's not astonishingly awful like I thought he was gonna be, but he's no one special either. Oh boy, then there's the Kirbys. I despise them. Well, except Eric, he's fine, I guess. He's not charming or relatable like Tim, but he's still cool and surprisingly funny. Like, really surprisingly, this movie is weirdly a lot funnier than the last two entries. Most of the jokes were very sly, but fit well in retrospect. So I do think this is a really funny movie, except for the Kirbys. Paul and Amanda might actually be my least favorite characters in the entire franchise. I'm not even joking. I wanted to get up and cheer in the theaters whenever it looked like Paul died. And I was six then, 6 freaking years old. I was so disappointed when I saw he survived, so disappointed. This movie also has a weird ending since it doesn't really have a final battle. However, those are really the only big problems I have with the film overall. The film also tells a really compelling family message similar to the original. I think it's important for a sequel to have a similar theme or branch out from the theme, and this film does that in a really good way, except for the fact that the Kirbys are at the center of the message. I can't believe it, but this movie would be unbelievably better without them in the story. I don't think this would have been a runner-up spot, but it would be very close. The Kirby would just have been cut. Despite this misstep, Jurassic Park 3 is nothing short of an incredible story with mostly fun characters with a great message. I know you want to hurt me, but I'm sorry. Jurassic Park 3 is my favorite Jurassic sequel, and you can't change my mind. Most likely when I watch back at this video when I'm 26, I'll be saying, what the heck was I thinking? My god, Jurassic World just gets even better every time I watch it. It's an action-packed, dramatic, climactic, and engaging experience. And man, was it a relief. I was so scared this one was going to turn out to be a complete and utter screw-up with just there for a pile of cash. Well, it didn't make a lot of money, but that's besides the point. I think one of the points that makes it so interesting is that it takes place in a full-running, operational theme park, which was a different take. Sure, the story starts off in a pretty unrealistic way. Like, the main reason they made the Indominus was because tourists were getting bored of dinosaurs? How do you get bored of dinosaurs? They're dinosaurs. Sure, the movie's relatively short, but man, they don't waste any time to get started. The Indominus was a conceptually sound idea. However, nothing groundbreaking. But somehow, they took this average story and turned it into a blummin' blockbuster. Even compared to Fallen Kingdom and the original, I will always stand by the fact that this film has the best CG in the franchise, or maybe even of all time. Even though Jurassic Park looked good for its time, and even today, this movie beats it completely. And may I tell you, I don't casually throw around the phrase, this movie does something better than Jurassic Park. Although it is still kind of unfair because this was released 20 years later, but whatever. This movie is beautiful, and not just the dinosaurs, the background sets of dinosaurs all look phenomenal. I also think Owen is a lot more compelling in this film than the second. Yeah, he's pretty much immortal, but he's still cool, and there's still tension. Like, who wouldn't love Chris Pratt riding on a motorcycle alongside velociraptors? Claire also gets a slight bit of development, which also comes in one of the most powerful scenes in the franchise, the Apatosaurus scene. Just a beautiful use of animatronic pieces to not only end a great character arc, but be a touching and moving at the same time. It's amazing seeing Claire realize that the animals she'd previously been calling assets were real. Real, living, breathing animals. It's truly incredible. Fallen Kingdom dreams of having a character arc that good. This movie is also really quotable at times. It has a fair share of comedic lines. This was also clearly a very professional movie. You can tell they pushed everything to the max with their cinematography, acting, and like I said, graphics. As you'd expect from a dinosaur film with a budget of $150 million to make, it is filled to the brim with tense and climactic action sequences. Speaking of action, dang was the ending something special. Seeing the three dinos battle each other was not only looked incredible, but was tense and exciting. With the Mosasaurus taking the last bite of Indy, that was quite the ride. As a whole, I think The Indominus was a lot more of a menacing threat, enjoyable to watch killer than the Indoraptor. And since this was the first time a hybrid concept was being used on the big screen, it still felt fresh. Not super fresh, but fresh. Blue is also considerably more likable than in Fallen Kingdom as well. I'm sorry, but although I immensely care for Blue, I don't think she's the most well-written character. At least in the second movie. Here, though, she's used enough. Enough that she's not insanely crucial to the plot, but still has purpose. She feels a lot more like a dinosaur than a pet. Even at the end of the film, Owen pets the side of her head, only to get the brace off. In Fallen Kingdom, however, halfway through the film, Owen literally strokes her on the head like she's a dog. They knew what they were doing. They knew. Undoubtedly, the dinosaur stuff here was extremely well handled. This is how you make a return of a franchise Universal. I'm talking to literally every other science fiction franchise in the world. This film is amazing, and it couldn't have been happier. Just talking about it makes me want to revisit it. But despite what I've said for the past 2 or 3 minutes, it's still not my favorite film. In fact, it's not even close. It comes to no one's surprise that Jurassic Park is number one. You can argue with things like the MonsterVerse, Alien, and Terminator on what the best film is. But with the Jurassic franchise, nothing even touches it. This movie is the sole reason why I love this franchise. It is an experience. And yes, I refer to this film as an experience, not a movie. An experience that leaves you a changed person by the end. Something truly incredible. I cannot even start to describe it with words. But I'll try my best. This experience tells such a captivating, emotional, in-depth story and family story. Family story. Other sci-fi movies wish they could tell a family story. It tells a story with such real characters. Real characters with depth, realism, and arcs. Everything is real. Everything is earned. This is Spielberg at his peak. This is cinema at his peak. I don't know who I'd be if it weren't for this movie. I can't even discuss it in this video. Not because I'm lazy, but because I can't even start to describe how this movie makes me feel. It needs its own 1 hour thought video that no one is gonna watch till the end. This film is real magic. Real, living magic. And until the end of time, it will not only stand as the greatest Jurassic Park movie, but the greatest film of all time. Except Dominion, of course! I really hope this movie will be good! But there you have it, my full ranking of the 5 Jurassic Park films. I might update it once Dominion comes out, we'll just have to see. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this ride, because I sure did. It was a blast watching all these films, mostly, for the bajillion time, and making and editing this video. I'm not going to tell you directly to like and subscribe, but if you're feeling generous, I wouldn't mind. Thank you and have a Jurassic day. What the heck was that?